Shalom Tzadikot. Today is the third day of the Sfirat HaOmer of the Minyan of Yesod Foundation. Today we're in Tiferet Shebayesod. Let's Be'ezrat Hashem ask from Hashem, Be'ezrat Hashem, that we'll have the zechut to greet Mashiach Tzidkenu B'Mehra B'Yameinu Amen. And may we all have the zechut to hear and see Eliyahu Navi Eliyahu Tishbi Eliyahu Gadi B'Mehra Yaveli Mashiach B'David Eliyahu Navi Zechu Latot. So we spoke about this, that the foundation is parallel to Yosef HaTzadik, Yosef the Righteous, Tzadik Yesod Elam, that is the foundation of the world. And V'siyata Dishmaya, it's written, B'micha Navi, Micha the Prophet, chapter 7, there are 13 attributes of Hashem. We know that we have that twice 13 attributes of Hashem. One is by Moshe Rabbeinu, Parashat Kitisa, Chumash Mot, over there, there are 13 attributes. It's Hashem, Hashem, Kel Chanun Barachum, Erech Apayim, Barav Chesed Ve'emet. These are the 13 attributes that Hashem gave to Moshe Rabbeinu after the sin of the golden calf, in order that these attributes will protect the body of the children of Israel, that they won't die. The 13 attributes that Micha Navi, Micha the prophet, received are the 13 attributes to protect the soul, the Siyata Dishmaya. So, it's written in them, Titen emet le'Yaakov chesed le'Avraham. You should grant truth to Yaakov and kindness to Avraham. Tiferet is parallel to Yaakov Avinu. Because Yaakov Avinu ish tam yoshev o'alim. He's an honest person, sits in between the tents, the tent of Avraham Avinu and the tent of Yitzchak, which is his measure. Tiferet, splendor, is the one that combines mercy and combines judgment together. So this is splendor inside the foundation. So we go back to Yosef HaTzadik. When we go back to Yosef HaTzadik, we see the Siyata Dishmaya, that after Yosef HaTzadik goes to find his brothers, and he finds them, they put him in a pit. And it's written by Rashi that in the pit there are no scorpions and snakes. And we see that he cries to his brothers, please take me from here. And instead of taking him back home to his father, they decide to sell him. Yehuda says to his brothers, let's sell it Yosef. And they sell him to the Ishmaelim, and the Ishmaelim sell him again until he comes to Mitzrayim. And then he works with Potipharah, and Potipharah sees that everything that he does, he's blessing Hashem. So he had prosperity and success in everything that he touched. Everything that he touched was gold. So he decides to give all of his keys, Potipharah, to Yosef HaTzadik, in order that he will flourish by him, by the blessings of Hashem that gives him. And we see that Potipharah's wife once has a desire for Yosef HaTzadik, and because he didn't want to be with her, they sent him to, she said that he raped her, and they threw him into jail. And Yosef HaTzadik is in jail. And he's in jail for a long time, for 12 years. So dear ladies, Rashi says, what does Yosef HaTzadik do in the jail? So Chazal say he's taking sparks of holiness under the nose of the policeman that is there, a soher, under the nose of the soher. But furthermore, Rashi says he's dancing, he's singing, and the person that will look from the side at the person who's dancing and singing inside a jail, Egyptian jail, will think that something is wrong, that maybe he lost his mind. But Yosef HaTzadik is so righteous, it's not that he lost his mind. He wants to say thank you to Hashem because he understands that everything that happens to him is from the hand of Hashem. How do we know that Yosef HaTzadik understands that the good and the things that seems not so good is from the hands of Hashem? Because Yosef HaTzadik says to his brothers, and we see that in Parashat Ve'yechi, he says, his brothers come to him after Yaakov Avinu passes away and they bury him. So they come to him and they says, we are going to be your slaves. Here we are going to be your slaves. Vayomer alehem Yosef, al tirau. Yosef tells them, don't be afraid. Ki hatachat Elokim anochi. Do you think that I'm instead of Hashem? He says, v'atem chashavtem alai ra'ah, you thought to do bad things to me, Elokim chashva letova, but Hashem thought, had a good thought in his mind. Leman aseh kayom hazeh, so I will come to this day, lachyot amram, and I can provide for you, for my brothers, and for everyone. So we see that Yosef HaTzadik, because the measure of Yaakov is truth, like it says in Bicha Navi, grant truth to Yaakov. From here we learn, it says, Agarach Mivolozhin says, in the book of Nefesh HaChaim, Shar Gimel Perek Yud Bet, the gate 3, chapter 12, it's written like this, Yesh Inyan Gadol Usgula Nifla, there's a big sgula, להסיר ולבטל מעליו כל דינים ורצונות אחרים. In order to take any judgment for yourself, and also that other people will not judge you and you'll be under their judgment. שלא יוכלו לשלוט בו, that you, they cannot control you, ולא יעשו שום רושם כלל, and they cannot do any sign or hurt you in any way. שאדם קובע בליבו. This is what we need to take upon ourselves. When a person puts inside his heart, לאמור, הלא השם הוא אלוקים, האמיתי, that השם is God, the true God, ואין עוד מלבדו, and there's no existence in this world except for השם. התברך שום כוח בעולם וכל העולמות כלל, which means there's nothing, everything is השם and השם is everything, in all worlds. והכל מלא רק אחדותו, and everything is in his unity, בסייעתא דשמיא. And he, והוא משגיח על העולם. He is the one that has השגחה פרטי, divine, a presence upon each person and person. ומשעבט, and we have to make our will the will of Hashem, which means we understand that any person, that nobody can hurt us, and nobody can do any good thing to us except for Hashem. Hashem sends a messenger either to do good things to us, or chas v'shalom, to do things that seem not so good to us. So b'siyata d'ishmael, when a person puts it in his heart that everything is from Hashem, which means he acknowledges the truth in this world, that we only came to this world for a partial time to do our tests and to succeed in it and to announce the name of Hashem in this world and to thank Hashem for everything. And with this midah, b'ezrat Hashem, we will greet Mashiach Tzidkenu b'mehrah bi'yameinu. Amen.